Afternoon everyone, it's Ian from DIY Home and Gardening. I've got a piece of wood behind me, pretty obvious. Planning to use it to do a new little build. Basically for my sister's birthday. Got no money and figured I'd make her a bird feeder. So let's get going, I suppose. Right, so that's my rough sketching. I mean, obviously you can tell it's a bird feeder. So base, support, back section, roof. And then the support will hold a bottle, which essentially will house all the seed in it. So yeah, I saw one of them in, well, something similar in a shop. Gave me a bit of an idea, so thought why not. So first thing is to cut some bits of wood to appropriate sizing. So I'm thinking the back section, I'll start off cutting it about 50 centimeters high. It'll be 10 centimeters wide, and then kind of make a base and top that will look proportionate, I suppose. There we are, so some very crude cutting. Back section 50 centimeters total height, then each of these are only 10 centimeters in width. And I'm just going to get the, well, I'm going to use a jigsaw to be honest because it'd be quicker. I'm then going to cut this so that it's only 10 centimeters wide, which essentially mean that that's it nice and flush like so. Make it a little bit less cumbersome, and then I'll cut these down as well in terms of width, so then it'll be a lot more streamlined. So that's the next job. Okay, so that's cut down to the 10 centimeter width. I ended up using the table saw instead of a jigsaw because, quite frankly, even quicker. And then really, I suppose, I just need to work out a rough sort of sizing for this top apex bit, where it's gonna look half reasonable and with a bit of an overhang. So you've got to, well, you haven't got to, but if you do a line like that to represent your halfway point and then see if you're happy with the overhang, alternatively, could do a top with a fixing like that to save having to worry about make it nice and fancy. Okay, so after a bit of I guess cutting, trialing, see how it looked, I've settled on that as dimensions. So that actually works out 12 centimeters from the shortest distance, if you like. So it's literally just setting up as a 45 degree cut. So that forms the apex. That is essentially laid out, and basically you could cut those bits at the very top to mirror the actual roof line, or leave it on and use that as your fixing bracket for what is to be the feeder. I think I'm going to leave it just because, well, it's going to be easier, isn't it? Right, back in the garage, going to set it up. So just need to obviously flip it over. And whilst I'm not going to fix this one yet, I'm just going to fix the bottom, but I'll use that as a bit of support. Make sure you use a decent length screw that you know is going to go through the bottom timber, whatever that is, and it wants to have similar sort of length again to go into the fixing timber. So if I just turn this over and then fix the basin. So having done the pilot holes, it's then up to you as to whether you want to just screw it straight down or use a glue for additional bonding. I've got some I'll show you. I've got some
dull indoor outdoor glue left over from when I was doing the bathroom skirting, so I'm just going to use a dab of that on each of these as well. And now I'll do exactly the same with this, so just screwing down from one into the other, and again if you want to glue, then glue. So with the roof built, next thing, mark where the middle of your section of timber is, draw a smallish line down, so then you can center the roof and screw it. Right, so with your centers marked out and line drawn into place, the easiest way I found is you can then draw a line across the top of the roof, take the roof away, gives you points then, so then you can drill from this side downwards, have many holes you see fit. In this case, I've gone for two each side. And then just means you can easily line that back up and then screw through from the other side. Again, it's entirely up to you if you want to use some glue. I definitely am. Right, okay, so at this point, gone for a bottle. Really just have a measure up as to what the top of a bottle is. So this one is about 30 mil or 3 centimeters. So I've had a little look in the shed and I've got one of these flat bits, that's a 35 mil. So that'd be plenty big enough, and also means that by using that, you can then put slightly larger headed bottles in there. So just work out where your center point is on there, and using the flat bit, I'm then going to drill a hole through. Right, there we are. So that's drilled out, and then you can see it slides over okay. And let's put it in rough position for you. So that's how it will sit. So I need to fix this in place now, and just want enough space really so that obviously you can undo the lid with some of the seed falling down into here, but not so far up that it then cascades everywhere, and equally not so tight down that you then can't get the lid off or no seed can come out. So I'm kind of thinking around about that sort of position will be, well, probably be great. As we're settled on the position, again, do the pencil line, just do it underneath so it's less conspicuous. Move that away, and then same as when we did the roof, can then do a couple of pilot holes through there. Run the glue if you're using glue, and then we can screw through from the other side. Okay, so that is my basic structure built. I suppose it's time for, if you want to do any finishing off touches. I mean, that is pretty secure like that, but I've got some old wire, it's bonsai wire actually, but I thought I might run that through and around just as a little bit of security, or make it look more vintage, bit of bling. And equally, I've got some old architrave, which again, I'm just going to cut some of that and fix that around the base, and then that'll act as a little bit of a retainer to stop the seeds dropping out onto the floor. Right, so put some pilot holes in the top so that can be used for hanging. I've drilled a couple of holes into the side, and essentially, as I say, I'm just going to use this old copper bonsaiing wire, and I'll pop that through, probably put it through a little bit more and just bend it on one side as my fixing point. And actually, this is the bottle of wine that I'm going to be giving as the gift, so that would then just band around and tie into position. There we are, doesn't that look good? So as I say, just bent through on one side, slightly bent on the other, just hold it. I've fixed, say, the base around, that's glued and screwed, and I've got a little bit, not very much paint left, so I'm just going to see whether I can touch up some of this just to make it a little bit more linked. Yeah, just getting the finishing touches done. A bit unsure, but I think I'm going to also do this face there just to give it a little bit of a lift, and then essentially that's it done. Just half hour drying time, and go around and give it a present. And with the last stroke of the brush, it is finished. So just half hour drying time, hopefully. Well, that is it. That's the end of the video. There's the bird feeder. You know, looks pretty good, I think, and certainly didn't take loads and loads of effort or time. Obviously, if you're watching this video, it's because it's after my sister's birthday. Not that I think she even follows me. But you guys aren't seeing the build before she does. And certainly, like I said at the start, I'd seen something similar in a shop, and so kind of copied the idea and then made it my own. So I think that's what all good artists, or whatever you want to call yourself, say. But anyway, if you like the video, then obviously please subscribe to the channel if you want to make sure that you're not missing out on the future videos that I'm doing. Then please click that reminder button, and that keeps you informed. If you do have any questions on this or any other project or gardening thing that I'm doing, or just generally need help with, then please send them over to me. I'm always happy to respond. And as much as anything, I say it with everything, you know, the planting or the DIY or little creative projects. Have fun, keep experimenting, and enjoy yourself. And till next time, bye for now, and take care.